Welcome, Cavalier Nation, to the first annual Cavalier ESPY Athletic Awards program. Tonight we celebrate history, all the incredible things that have taken place during this athletic year at Cuthbertson High School. It's been an exciting year. We've had fantastic finishes, record-breaking performances, and of course, state championships won. And yes, it was devastating not to be able to complete our spring season as it was cut unexpectedly short. But we've been so inspired by you athletes about the way you have persevered through this process. You've truly shown us what it means to live our covenant, rise as one. A special note to those spring sports seniors and all spring sports athletes. While we didn't get to finish that championship chase on the field, you guys are all incredible champions for the way that you have persevered through this. And you will forever be better, stronger, more perseverant men and women for it. Thank you for all of your efforts. And tonight we dedicate this program to you, spring sports athletes, especially our seniors in the program. We love you guys, we miss you guys, and we're gonna be excited when we see you again. For those moving on to play collegiately, we know you're gonna be terrific from the foundation you've built here, and we can't wait to celebrate those things as you go on in your careers as well. I'd like to say several thank yous tonight. First and foremost, I want to thank all the student athletes. The heart and soul that you pour into your careers here as Cavaliers is incredible, and it's reflected in the results that we have. Hallways filled with your likeness, trophy cases marking the history that you've made here. It's incredible what you pour in, and it's incredible what you get out of it. So thank you. Thank you to our incredible coaching staff. You guys pour in hours and hours and hours of dedication to help these student athletes achieve their dreams. We couldn't do it, we couldn't see the success we do without your commitment. Thank you. To the community, the parents, our faculty and staff that consistently fill the stands, it's amazing the energy that we have here in Cavs Nation. We love being a part of it. Our environment is one of the things that makes us proudest of being Cavaliers. Thank you to all of you for the way you provide that. I'd also like to thank our administration team, Mr. Stout, Mr. Brooks, Ms. Monteith, and Dr. DeCudo. Countless hours after school and through the evenings supervising athletic events. I want to thank our own school resource officer, Jim Kennedy, as well as middle school resource officer, Mike Gallagher, for the constant and consistent security you provide at our athletic events. I'd like to thank our team doctor, Dr. Eric Warren, as well as our athletic trainers, Danny Promutico and Missy Woodward. The consistent work that you have done to prepare and rehab our athletes is crucial to our success. Thank you. I'd also like to thank the Cuthbertson Athletic Booster Club and its executive board members, Rosalind Pollock, Amber Hart, Wayne Hedden, and Wendy Arner, as well as committee chairs, Donna Smith and Suzanne Crump. Incredible the amount of time that you guys have put in to making this program grown and build, the financial commitment, the capital projects we've been able to do, it's amazing. In particular, this year's lighting project, which the Booster Club handled funding for. Thank you so much for all your commitment and dedication to the excellence at Cuthbertson High School. I want to say two last thank yous, a special note of thanks to our Chief Athletic Administration intern, Nicole Scarbeck. Your work all year to help get events going, to help do graphics, promotions, music, and everything has made this an incredible year. Also want to thank TJ Kohlbrenner and Cuthbertson Film Club for their efforts in putting together tonight's program. Thank you all. We look forward to tonight and hope you enjoy the program. Now let's take a look back at the fall sports season.
Be the last one standing, two hands in the air, I'm a champion. You'll be looking up at me when it's over. I live for the battle, I'm a soldier. Yeah, I'm a fighter like Rocky. Put your flag on your back like Ali. Yeah, I'm the greatest, I'm stronger. Bet my dues can't lose, I'm my own, yeah. Hey, I've been working my whole life.
bets on me.
For the courage I possess through the drama. H is for the hurt, but it's all for the honor. A is for my attitude, working through the patience. Money comes and goes, so the M is for motivation. Gotta stay consistent, the P is to persevere. The I is for integrity, innovative career. The O is optimistic, open and never shut. And the N is necessary, cause I'm never giving up. See, they ask me how I did it, I just did it from the heart. Crushing the competition, been doing it from the start. They say that every champion is all about his principles. Carry.
I'm honored to present our next award, the Comeback Player of the Year Award. As athletes, we all know that it takes a lot of work, a lot of hard work in order to get ready for the season. A lot of weightlifting, a lot of sweat, a lot of tears go into that. But when you're battling back from an injury, it's that much more. Then once you get healthy and you're ready to touch the field or court again, well, then you have to battle that mental game to see if you're really ready to go. This year's athletes went beyond and above all of that in order to come back and help their teams win. Our first nominee is going to be Jack Reinhart, football. Suffered a broken collarbone in 2018 and was able to battle back through the offseason to start at running back for the Cavs in his first game of the season and help us on our playoff run. Our second nominee is Blake Mettler. At the beginning of the 2019 season, he had a torn labrum and was able to come back in order to help our wrestling team make the playoffs for the first time in a few years, and then was able to actually wrestle at regionals. So very proud of both of these athletes for what they were able to endure, come back, and compete. And this year, your winner is Jack Reinhart.
Congratulations to running back Jack Reinhart on winning Comeback Athlete of the Year for Cuthbertson. Jack showed extreme character this year by battling through injuries throughout his career and starting at running back for the Cuthbertson Cavaliers. Jack will do extremely well in the future based on what he's done here at Cuthbertson, and we're extremely proud of you. Go Jack.
Here. I am here to announce the Cavalier Courage Award. This award goes to the athlete that displays an attitude, energy, and perseverance through success or struggle and exemplifies the courage of a Cavalier and inspires others. This year's nominees are Adam Smith, Evan Bernard, and Omar Abid. And the winner is Adam Smith. Congratulations!
Adam, or as everybody knows you, Smitty, congratulations on the Cavalier Courage Award, man. You seriously deserve this award. Everybody knows that you deserve this award for all the hard work that you put in. You know, you weren't always the best athlete, the fastest athlete, the strongest athlete, but you are by far the one person that has put in the most work over the last 4 years. Everything that you've done, you should be proud of. You know, whenever we watch the warm-ups happening at practice, you're the final one running all four laps. You know, some of your teammates might not finish all four, but you are making sure that you get all four of those warm-up laps in. You're making sure that you go from the sprint workout over to the throws to make sure that you get those done. You show up every day. Everybody's so happy to be around you. You make the world a better place. You make our team and our school a better place. I'm so proud of you, Smitty. All right. All the other coaches are proud of you. The staff, administration, everyone's so proud of you, Smitty. And we are so excited that you were able to win this award today. Congratulations.
Cavs fans, Coach Walsh here, and it is my distinct honor and privilege to announce this year's Under Armour Most Undeniable Performance Award. And your nominees are Cade Keeler from Cuthbertson Baseball. Cade threw an opening day complete game no-hitter with 7 strikeouts against Weddington. Aiden McNally from Cuthbertson Track. Aiden won 3 state championship medals at this year's Indoor Track State Championships. And Allison Tomey from Cuthbertson Swim and Dive. Allison won 2 state championship medals at this year's Swim and Dive State Championships. And your winner is Cade Keeler from Cuthbertson Baseball. Congratulations, Cade, on an awesome performance, on beating Weddington, and doing it with a no-hitter. We're all super proud of you, buddy. Go Cavs.
Hey, Cade, I want to congratulate you on winning the Undeniable Performance Award. You know, that night was pretty special. In your senior year, first home game against our rival Weddington, and to do what you did and pitch the way that you pitched was pretty incredible. For those watching, you know, every no-hitter has a backstory or an inside story that most don't know about. So I think it was Cade's second at bat. He hit a double off the wall, and as he was rounding second base, he twisted his ankle. It looked pretty bad from where I was in the dugout, and I really assumed that he was going to be taken out of the game. And as he got closer to the bench, I asked him, you know, I said, "Is it hurt?" And he said, "Yes, it hurts a lot. Are you able to go?" And he's like, "I think so." So, you know, after a few minutes, he was limping around, and I made the decision that I was going to pull him. Our total season was more important than furthering the injury. But he insisted on going back in, and pretty incredible that he couldn't even put a lot of weight on his landing foot, and to do what he did was incredible. And honestly, that event was pretty undeniable. So again, Cade, congratulations. Good luck in your future, and I'll talk to you soon.
King Kong banging on your chest. You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. Yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero. You could get the gold. Breaking all the records he thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people. Do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country. Do it for your name. Cause
There's gonna be a day when you're
nominees for the Breakthrough Athlete of the Year are John Newton, baseball. Reagan Iovino, women's basketball. Lillian Nasta, cross country and track. AJ Colombo, football and lacrosse. And Gabriela Castro, cross country and track. And the 2019-2020 Breakthrough Athlete of the Year is Reagan Iovino, women's basketball.
Hey sports fans, we all love to watch that one player that leaves us on the edge of our seat every time they touch the ball. My 11 years of coaching the girls here at Cutlasson, we've never had a player that can get the entire gym and Cav Nation into a frenzy and change the momentum of a game like 5'3" Reagan Iovino. It was amazing to watch our student section and fans rally behind her and the Lady Cavs this season. As a freshman, sometimes it's hard to come in and make an immediate impact, but Reagan instantly became a fan favorite and united our team, fans, and community in our quest to chase down the state title. I am truly honored to present Reagan with this year's Breakthrough Athlete of the Year Award. Congrats, Reagan.
Hey Cavaliers, this is your old athletic trainer, Carlos Rodriguez. I've been blessed with the opportunity to present the Best Team Award for Cuthbertson this year. Part of what makes good teams good is obviously having athletic talent. Part of what makes those good teams great is having athletic talent, plus being able to gel and work together to accomplish their goals. These next four nominees exemplify all of those traits. The following nominees are girls cross country, two-time defending state champions and number one ranked team in the Southeast U.S. after the 2019 season. Girls indoor track, four-time defending state champions. Wrestling, SCC conference runner-up and state championship qualifier. Girls basketball, SCC champs, number three seed, and advanced to the fourth round of the state playoffs. And the winner is women's indoor track. Go Cavs.
It is such a great honor to be nominated and then to win the team of the year. This year's girls team was absolutely amazing. A lot of things that people don't know is this team was able to score the most points ever at a state championship, scoring 106.5 points. But what was even more impressive was this was the greatest team that we've ever had at Cuthbertson High School. And what I mean by that is we've scored in every event. We scored in the high jump, the long jump, the pole vault. We scored in distance races. We scored in sprint races. We won the 4x2, the 4x4. We had a state champion in the pole vault. We did everything that we had to do, and everybody showed up on that day. And that is why we are the team of the year, because we all came together on a daily basis to do everything that each one of us had to do to be the best we could be. And in turn, that turned us into the best team we could be. So be proud of the fact that you were nominated, be proud of the fact that you have won this award, and be proud of the fact that you've won 4 straight state championships. But this team is the best team that North Carolina has ever seen at the Indoor Track and Field State Championship. Thank you so much again for the award, and congratulations to all the amazing girls on the 2020-2021 Indoor Track and Field team.
My name is Trey Cavanaugh, head football coach for your Cuthbertson Cavaliers. I'm here today to announce the winner of Best Championship Performance. The first nominee is Allison Tome. Allison was a 2-time state champion at this year's Swim and Dive Championship meet. The second nomination is Aiden McNally. Aiden was a 3-time state champion at this year's Indoor Track and Field State Championship meet. The third nominee is Mackenzie Townsend. Mackenzie won 2 championships at this year's Indoor State Track and Field meet. And the winner is Aiden McNally. Congratulations, Aiden.
Aiden, congratulations on winning the Best Championship Performance. I don't know how you can really compete with someone that went out there and won 3 state championships, especially in the dominating fashion that you did. You know, coming out, winning the 300, winning the 4x2, and winning the 4x4, being the anchor on both legs, was absolutely amazing. The fact that you had the strength and the endurance to go through that entire meet has been absolutely amazing. I'm astonished by you every single time I see you run. I'm so glad that you're here for another year. And next year, how about we make it 4x4? How about we win that 55 too? All right, buddy, keep working. Congratulations again, and we'll see you next year.
Yeah.
Cavs Nation. Great to be back with you tonight, and it's my honor now to present the nominees for this year's Coach of the Year Award. Three tremendous nominees this year. Number one, Kirk Walsh, head coach of women's and men's cross country, the two-time defending women's cross country state champions. The team also finished this year as the number one ranked program in the Southeast. Kirk Walsh received national recognition this year from the USA Track and Field and Cross Country Coaches Association as the North Carolina Women's Cross Country Coach of the Year. Joel Allen. Joel Allen is coming off a second consecutive year where he led our girls basketball program deep into the state playoffs. Coach Allen was named the Southern Carolina Conference Coach of the Year. Third, Dustin Allen. Coach Allen has been the head coach of our track program for the last several years. They are the four-time defending women's indoor track state champions. Coach was also named the Charlotte Observer Track Coach of the Year. And this year's winner is Dustin Allen.
It's an absolute honor to be up for the Coach of the Year Award with all the amazing coaches that we have at Cuthbertson High School. I mean, Coach Blackwell has put together an amazing staff for all of our different sports. So it's just an amazing opportunity to be nominated. It's even more to be named the first Coach of the Year in Cuthbertson High School for these ESPY Awards. I'd like to take a lot of the credit, but I just can't. The credit is not mine for this award. This award really goes out to everybody that does all the hard work, and that is the assistant coaches. You know, from our pole vault coach, Coach Wood, who has a state champion this year, to our long and triple jump coach who really helps out in the weight room with Coach Gore, to our throws coach with Coach East, and then it goes to the two that have been here since day one. It goes to Coach Lightfoot, who did an amazing job with our sprinters this year, the boys and the girls winning the 4x2 and 4x4 state championships. Just goes to show what he's been doing. And then the most integral part to the distance program is Carla Stamper, who's been doing an absolute amazing job and really had great strategy going into the state championship this year in order to win that fourth straight. So it's an absolute amazing honor. I'm very honored for this award. I thank all of Cavs Nation, and I can't wait to see everybody continue to do amazing work in the years moving forward. Go Cavs!
Hi again, Cavalier Nation. Let's talk about great records in sports. Cal Ripken Jr. played in 2,632 consecutive Major League Baseball games. Joe DiMaggio gets a hit in 56 straight Major League Baseball games. And Wilt Chamberlain scores 100 points in a single NBA contest. These are some of the great records in sports history. And this year at Cuthbertson High School saw no shortage of incredible performances ourselves. This year's nominees for best record-breaking performance are women's swim and dive. The 200 medley relay team set a new North Carolina state record en route to capturing a state championship in that event. Aiden McNally took the indoor track and field championships by storm, recording three championship performances in a single meet. Reagan Iovino shattered the Cuthbertson women's basketball high school record for threes made in a single season of 61, recording 80 this season. Women's track saw their 4x400 relay team set a new school record en route to capturing a state championship in that event as well. And Gabriela Castro broke the old school record, running in 18 minutes and 1 second and leading to a runner-up finish at the women's cross country state championships. And the winner of this year's best record-breaking performance is Reagan Iovino, shattering the Cuthbertson High School school record for threes in a single season with 80. Congratulations, Reagan. Great accomplishment for you, and a great career is underway for you here as a Cavalier. Well done.
Hey, Cavs, I'm honored to present this year's record-breaking performance to Reagan Iovino. Reagan set a school record for most three-pointers made in a season. She made 80 of 186 on the season. those of you bad at math, that's 43%. The previous record was held by current Cavalier assistant coach Taylor Helms, who was 61 of 159 for 38% her junior season. Based on my research, Reagan made the most threes by a freshman in a season in the state history of North Carolina. Reagan recorded 10 games this year in which she made four or more three-pointers. It was my pleasure to watch all 80 of her made three-pointers from the sideline this season, and I know that Reagan and her teammates can't wait to get back on the court next year to break some more records. Congrats, Reagan, on a record-breaking performance.
What's up, everybody? I'm Trevor Grant, and I was honored to be the Male Athlete of the Year last year for the class of 2019 at Comfort Center. And I'm very excited to announce the 2020 Male Athlete of the Year. There's some incredible talent on the list of nominees this year. Despite the setbacks of coronavirus on the spring season, these athletes still managed to accomplish so much this year. So first, I'm going to start this list off with Cade Kuehler. Cade led the Cavs baseball team with a no-hitter on opening day against Weddington and finished 2-0 as a staff ace this year. The baseball club was able to sweep Weddington to start their season, and Cade played a huge role. The next nominee is Aiden McNally. As a junior, Aiden walked away from the indoor track state championship with three gold medals around his neck. Aiden won the 300, led the 4x2 and 4x4 teams to the first place finishes, and helped lead the men's track team to the program's first ever state runner-up. Up next is Cuthbertson football's A.J. Colombo. As a sophomore, A.J. led the Cavaliers with over 1,000 all-purpose yards and brought back 7 touchdowns. A.J. finished his season on the SEC football all-conference list and is the team offense MVP. Last but not least is cross-country and track stud Mickey Shield. Mickey finished his junior year as an all-county, all-region, and all-state cross-country athlete this year. Not to mention, he's a school record holder in cross-country with a time of 16 minutes even. Now that all the nominees have been listed, I just want to say again that there is some incredible talent and potential, not only on this list, but on all rosters for men's sports this past year. And without any further ado, the 2020 Men's Athlete of the Year is Aiden McNally. Congratulations, Aiden, and congratulations to all the athletes part of the Cuthbertson ESPYs this year. All of you have great potential, and I am very excited to follow y'all's journey in the coming years. I hope everyone watching this stays safe and healthy, and God bless you all. See you later, Cavs Nation.
Aiden, congratulations on winning this year's Male Athlete of the Year. You definitely deserve this award for everything that you were able to do this year. You know, coming from your sophomore year, you really had to grow up this year and become a leader, and you did everything that you needed to do between taking weightlifting class, you know, coming out there every day and working hard and really setting the example for all of your teammates to do what we've done. You know, to bring our team for the second straight year to be state runner-ups at the state meet, winning 3 state championships in one meet. Everything that you've done is absolutely amazing. From your record-breaking performance in the 300 this year to your record-breaking performances in the 4x2 and 4x4, you are truly an amazing athlete, and I cannot wait to see what you can do next year to try to top this off. Congratulations, man.
Spirit of a Champion Award recognizes an athlete who exemplifies the true qualities of a champion in and out of competition with their care, leadership, and passion towards others. This year's nominees are Gabriella Castro, cross country, track and field; Lauren Hartman, women's basketball; Leander Chance, wrestling, track and field; Kaylee Ross, swimming; and Madeline Hill, cross country, track and field. The 2019-2020 Spirit of a Champion Award winner is Leander Chance, wrestling, track and field.
Congratulations on winning the Spirit of a Champion Award. When I was asked to make this nomination, I could think of no better example in the school than what you've set. The wrestling team, your junior year, when you decided to make a starting spot your own and staying after practice, you have no idea the events that you set forward by staying after practice every day and working hard and showing the example of what hard work can achieve. Congratulations, buddy. You deserve it.
What's up, Cavs? Kaylin McKinney here. For those of you who don't know me, I'm a proud graduate of the class of 2019. I'm also a former member of the women's basketball and soccer programs. I'm so excited to be announcing to you today the 2019-2020 Female Athlete of the Year Award. Our four nominees are Mackenzie Townsend, two-time state champion at Indoor Track Championships. Allison Tome, two-time state champion at Swim and Dive Championships. Maddie Dillinger, SCC Player of the Year for Women's Basketball. And Gabriella Castro, individual runner-up at Cross Country State Championship, team champions, and she also holds the record for girls cross country. And our winner is Mackenzie Townsend. Congratulations, Mackenzie.
Mackenzie, congratulations on winning Female Athlete of the Year. You absolutely deserve it. Everything that you've put out there on the track these past 4 years has been nothing but the best. From winning four straight state championships, winning a state championship every year that you've been in school, to closing out your final meet, winning the 4x2 and 4x4 state championships is absolutely amazing. Everything you've done on the track has been exceptional, but what you've done off the track has been even more. Your leadership is something that we are seriously going to miss. No one has been a good of a leader as you have been. You care so much for your teammates. You care so much for this team. And I think that is why you're being recognized as well. Not only are you an amazing athlete, you're an amazing student, and you're an even better person. I'm so proud of you for winning this award. I'm so proud of you for accomplishing everything that you've accomplished, and I cannot wait to watch you at UNCW next year. Congratulations once again. Can't wait to continue watching your success.
All right, Cavaliers. That wraps up tonight's program. Thank you so much for joining us to celebrate the incredible accomplishments of this year's student athletes and all of our programs here at Cuthbertson High School. Congratulations to every one of our nominees, and of course to all of our winners in this year's awards program. We look forward to seeing you again. Everybody stay happy, healthy, and safe this summer, and we can't wait to get back to athletics when the fall rolls around.